Now the next dish that we are going to make is mutton nilgiri korma. For that I have already boiled my mutton. Now if you go in a restaurant and you order that dish in a hotel, they keep the mise en place ready. So that's the same thing that I have done today. I will be showing you mutton, how what I did to that mutton later on. First I'll have a look here. Curry leaves I have, peppercorns I have some cardamom, I have bay leaf and cinnamon. Now what I did with mutton, I took that mutton, I washed it. Now mutton is 250 grams boneless and 250 grams with the bone. So I took that mutton, I added some ginger garlic, green chili paste, some salt and turmeric, and I at least cooked for an hour. Okay, and I have some stock also of that mutton. We call it yakni in Hindi, okay. That's an Indian stock, okay. In English you can also call it a bouillon. Bouillon is the unclarified stock that we need, that will give again nice taste to the gravy. We have some cumin here, coriander powder, chopped tomatoes, paste of onion, salt, garlic, ginger, oil, turmeric, your chili, and we have a nilgiri paste. Now what is nilgiri paste? A green paste. The main ingredient in the nilgiri paste is your mint and coriander, okay, and coconut and chili. So I grounded together them. It's a wet masala, okay. I gave you example of dry and wet masala in my theory chapter. So that is what wet masala we have. Now I will be adding also one ingredient that I don't have here, maybe it's kept there. We have some spinach puree. Now why we are adding spinach puree in the recipe? Just to retain the color back, because when you cook that mutton, mint and coriander in the initial stage, it turns black. To retain the color, we'll be adding some blanched spinach puree. Now step one, we'll be adding oil. Too hot, so don't burn your garam masala. You can add bay leaf, some peppercorn, cinnamon goes in there, cumin, that's it. Curry leaf is optional, but I love curry leaf when I like some curry leaf. I have it. Some more paste coming in here. When you see the onion is getting color, okay, so you can add your ginger garlic paste. What's the ginger here? We are adding some turmeric. Some chili powder. Very little. That's it. And some coriander. Simultaneously, I'll be adding my milk. This wet masala at least for 5 to 6 minutes till it is cooked completely and it leaves all the oil and the masala should be cooked. So we'll be cooking that 5 minutes, so we'll come back after 5 minutes. Cook the wet masala, the oil is oozing out from the pan, masala is cooked completely. Now I'll be adding my mutton with that stock, the yakni I told you. When you add mutton, again add some water and let it cook again for at least 10 minutes. Okay, and then I'll be adding last ingredient, that is my blanched spinach puree. You can see this puree is there. I have some more over there, so I'll be adding more. Okay, and I'll be adding my salt as well. So we'll come again after 10 minutes. It's nicely cooked. Okay, now I'll be adding my last ingredient, that is my blanched spinach puree. That will give me nice green color. This puree, the reason we are adding blanched spinach puree today, to retain that green color. And now we will be adding this puree, we will not be cooking more than 2 minutes.
because again the color will fade away. You know that chlorophyll is present in spinach. Overcooking will fade away the color. And finishing with some salt. Last final ingredient. We're cooking this for 2 minutes and Nilgiri korma is done.